Good evening, everyone. This is Cruz de la Cruz with Stephen Fiennes. Breaking news starting us off here on Rise. Ain't that right, Stephen?
Absolutely. A killer way to start Rise with some breaking news. As we see Tiffany Owens here, the manager of Downtown Bruno Brown, due to his actions on the last episode of Fight Night, Big Terry Mack has challenged Downtown Bruno Brown to a match at WrestleEmpire. Yeah, but Bruno Brown accepted under one condition, that it's a tag match. And look who it is, Cruz.
Is this his tag partner?
It's world-famous pop star Justin Bieber. And I do have it on good authority that, yes, Justin Bieber will be Downtown Bruno Brown's tag team partner at WrestleEmpire against Big Terry Mack and a partner of his choosing.
My goodness, that is blockbuster news.
I can't believe Justin Bieber is here in the flesh.
I figured you'd know since you and Bruno are butt buddies.
He must have kept this on the hush. But yeah, I told you Downtown Bruno Brown knows people. He has very famous friends. And Justin Bieber, it doesn't get any more famous than Justin Bieber.
I can't disagree with you there, Steven. But look at these guys. Ugh.
It's such a great sight. You love to see it, Cruz.
What, Bruno with them painted on jeans and Bieber in his slides?
He's fashionable.
The slides are fashionable.
That's how they dress in Europe, Cruz.
Ugh. We're not in Europe.
He's very European.
If you say so. But out next, Tiffany Owens facing Serenity here in one-on-one action.
Out comes Big Terry Mack's best friend, former Toronto North Dance Crew member Serenity. Coming out with Big Terry Mack. And you gotta wonder who Big Terry Mack is gonna get to be his tag team partner at WrestleEmpire.
Oh, you know it's gonna be big. You know Big Mack.
Oh, that's the only way Big Mack can go is big.
Oh, I can't wait to see who he picks at WrestleEmpire. Oh, man.
And the crowd is loving Big Terry Mack at Serenity here tonight on Rise.
Oh, they always do.
Getting the crowd all fired up, getting themselves all fired up. And Serenity will go one-on-one with Tiffany Owens here in the opening match of Rise.
Man, what a way to kick off Rise, our go-home show before WrestleEmpire.
Absolutely, and WrestleEmpire will be a two-night spectacular.
Right you are, Steven, and Tiffany Owens taking it to Serenity right off the bat here. And now that we know these individuals rode to WrestleEmpire, let's see how the rest of the night unfolds. And I'm being told that we will be announcing more matches as the night goes on. Tiffany, oh, big uppercut just rocked her there. Serenity fighting back here. Oh, big drop kick. You know, I mean, I would say that, you know, Serenity definitely has an advantage over Tiffany Owens. I mean, Serenity is an actual athlete. You know, Tiffany Owens is a manager.
I mean, yeah, on paper, yeah, this is a very much a mismatch. But at the same time, you can't count out Tiffany Owens, just her heart. You know, she's giving it all she's got.
I guess. You know, anyone that hangs out with Bruno as much as her, I can't give too much credit to.
Such a hater, Cruz.
And that dirt,
such a hater.
And that dirtbag Bieber out there, jeez.
Hey, now, he is a guest here in ESW. Let's treat him with some respect,
No one invited him.
Bruno invited him.
Well, the ESW universe certainly didn't invite him.
Hey, he speaks for himself. He doesn't speak for everyone, Beeps.
Oh, we're well aware. Oh, jeez. Tiffany Owens actually showing quite an aggression here. Oh, dumping Serenity to the apron.
Knocks
her down.
Knocking her off the apron right in front of Downtown Bruno Brown and Justin Bieber. The dream team, as far as I'm concerned.
Oh, I'm sure you would think that. You probably think they deserve a tag title shot.
I mean, if the inevitable weren't in that match already, I would suggest it.
Oh, Tiffany with a big super kick, but Serenity coming back with an elbow and a right hand. Tie up here. Oh, Serenity. Oh, to the kidneys. Jeez. Oh, but Tiffany fighting back. This has been actually surprisingly back and forth match here. Oh, big bulldog.
Tiffany Owens, impressive bulldog. She's going for a suplex. Oh! A knee smash instead.
Oh man, Tiffany just rocked her with that one.
Serenity doesn't know where she's at right now. Two count.
Oh, rope break.
Too close to the rope. The ring awareness of Tiffany Owens isn't quite there.
I'll give it to Bruno, though. He's trained Tiffany pretty well.
Well, of course he has.
And Steven, I can't... Anytime I try to throw him any type of bone, you have to take it to the next level.
Well, because, why wouldn't you give Bruno his flowers? Earned them.
I'm trying to be impartial here, and you have to make it work.
You're the only person who has a problem here, Cruz.
Oh, me and the other thousands of people in the arena. Yeah, we're the only people. You're the only one that likes him.
I am not the only person.
Okay, you and Denise Delisle. You're the only ones who fanboy or fangirl over this dude. Oh, code red by Serenity. Oh, two count, though.
And Serenity impressive in her own right during this match.
Oh, for sure. Oh, the slings are over by her hair. Oh, stepping on her hair. Oh, that's gotta hurt.
Man, that looks painful.
Oh, Serenity. Rocking and rolling here. Big Mac cheering her on here. Oh, got her by the throat. What's she have in mind? Oh, just slammed her down.
A variation of an STO.
Oh, just stomping her out. Look at that.
Big Mac looks very pleased with his best friend, Serenity.
Oh, absolutely. You know, it's funny that when Big Mac challenges Bruno to a match at Empire, Bruno don't have the guts to face him one-on-one. You know, that's what I see at all of this.
But Bruno is a showman, and it's the biggest event of the season. Wow, what a splash.
Oh, man. That could be it. And that's it. Serenity, big win here. Bruno and Bieber visibly distraught, and I like it.
Huge victory for Serenity here in the opening contest of Rise. And Tiffany Owens, very impressive in this match, but at the end of the day, experience ruled the day, and now Serenity with a big victory on Rise. Who will be Big Mac's partner at WrestleEmpire? I guess we'll just get to find out.
All right, guys, out next, we have the Phantom, Michael Temple, in his last match against the Brothers of the Chosen.
Absolutely. He's already defeated Brother Noah and Brother Levi in one-on-one action, and now all that's left is Brother Isaiah. If he can defeat Brother Isaiah here tonight, then the Phantom will go one-on-one with Father Peter at WrestleEmpire.
Oh, you know the Phantom is just chomping at the bit to take out Brother Isaiah here tonight.
We have not seen Brother Noah or Brother Levi since being defeated by the Phantom. One has to think if Father Peter is punishing them.
Oh, I would think so. You know, I wonder if he went as far as excommunicating them.
Might have them locked up somewhere, having to watch more instructional videos.
That sounds awful.
More PowerPoint presentations by Father Peter. I'd rather be waterboarded.
He is a master of PowerPoint. All right, guys, the Phantom here, getting this crowd fired up here, as he always does. You know this guy, he just has a aura about him, a big fight feel every time the Phantom enters the arena. All right, guys, I can't wait for this. You know, and I'm definitely on Team Phantom here against the Chosen. Well,
well, we all know you're unbiased, Bruce.
I have to be. I'm a color commentator.
Well, here comes the last piece of the puzzle here. The Phantom has to defeat Brother Isaiah in order to get his one-on-one match with Father Peter at WrestleEmpire. It's going to be another tall task, and in accompanying Brother Isaiah to the ring is Sister Miriam, who, you know, she had an interesting interaction with the Phantom in his match with Brother Levi. It looks like Brother Levi was instructing her to do things, to get involved, and she was not having any of it.
Oh, yeah, I remember. It was, you know, quite telling. All right, the last challenge for the Phantom is see if he can knock off the behemoth, Brother Isaiah here, the biggest of the brothers. I would definitely say the meanest, too, and the ugliest.
Oh, I was just about to say, yeah, they're definitely the most unattractive member of the Chosen.
No, Miriam ain't that bad once you look at her. Once she dropped that dead pan on her face, you know.
Oh yeah, once that trance that, you know, Father Peter has put every member of the Chosen under, you know, once that was dropped, you know, yeah, you can see it. You can see it there.
Yeah, you can see why the Phantom has become enamored with her. Oh, big front slam. And this may be too much for the Phantom.
Phantom's coming off that grueling match with Brother Levi on the last episode of Fight Night, so he's not 100% right now.
Oh, big stomp to the elbow.
Brother Isaiah taking advantage of that fact. Sizing the Phantom up right now.
Oh, big double axe handle.
Taking the Phantom down, and now deadlifting him off the mat and throwing him like a sack of garbage. Now the Phantom is being manhandled right now. More strength on display by Brother Isaiah.
Just hoisting him up there.
And just holding him there. All that blood rushing to the Phantom's head.
Phantom with the elbow. He may have caught him in the Johnson. Oh.
Now a Thez press taking the Brother Isaiah down, right hands.
Oh, and that big right hand from the Phantom.
The Phantom knows what's on the line in this match.
Oh man, big knee strike. Phantom tying him up here. Cradles him over. Oh, and that backbreaker.
Just wearing the big man down.
And that's what he has to do.
Smart strategy. Another big right hand by the Phantom, Michael Temple.
He can't let Isaiah get his big mitts on him.
Oh, looks like he's going for the music of the night.
I think Isaiah may be too big and strong for him to hold this on too long.
I think you're right, Cruz. He's powering out right now.
Oh, man. Missed that boot. Both missed there. Big double axe handle. Into the corner. Oh, man.
Uppercut.
Now, Phantom's uppercut is a thing of beauty.
Oh, it's textbook.
Oh, wait a minute.
He presses the Phantom up.
Oh, and he drops him.
Face first onto the mat, into the cover.
Oh, and Phantom kicks out. Gonna take more than that. Oh, block.
The Phantom is way too motivated right now. Into the ropes, drop down. Leapfrog.
Oh.
Sidestepped him.
Another sidestep into a German.
Man, a snap German suplex on a Brother Isaiah.
Whipping him to the corner.
Grabs and whips him to the opposite corner. Splash right, by the Phantom.
Right in front of Miriam.
And now they're having words. It looks like the Phantom is telling her, you don't have to do this.
And she gets down.
And the masquerade. And now he's going to put an exclamation point on it. Another masquerade. Into a cover.
Did you see that? Miriam listened to it.
She did. And three. The Phantom Michael Temple has done it. He will go one-on-one with Father Peter at WrestleEmpire.
What a match, man. And, oh, man, I think the biggest development here is that Sister Miriam listened to the Phantom.
He told her she didn't have to do this, and she listened. She got off the apron. And then the masquerade ended it all for Brother Isaiah. So now Father Peter will have to meet the Phantom Michael Temple one-on-one at WrestleEmpire.
All right, guys, we got more action here tonight. Diamonds action. Your favorite action, Steven. And it definitely is one of mine. We have the Cougar, Casey Taylor, out here for one-on-one action.
Absolutely, and we do have breaking news. Another match confirmed for WrestleEmpire, just like the men's claim to fame five-way match, with the winner receiving an ESW title match at any time, anywhere, of the winner's choosing. We will also have a Diamonds claim to fame five-way match at WrestleEmpire. In that match is the Japanese firecracker Romy Sakamoto, the Brooklyn baddie Denise Delisle, the head of the Moretti crime family Sophia Moretti, and the beautiful and powerful Coda Rosa. Now the fifth and final member will be the winner of this match. It will either be the Cougar Casey Taylor, or it will be Tokyo Rose.
Quite an announcement. Nothing but big announcements here on our go-home show for WrestleEmpire. All right, guys, Tokyo Rose making her way out here. Very energetic, always gets the crowd going. And that's the thing, both these competitors, the crowd loves them both. You know, this should be quite a contest. Everyone is happy, especially you.
Oh, absolutely. Gotta love Diamonds action. And, of course, with the Cougar, Casey Taylor, it's even more so. Yeah, and you gotta wonder who's going to be the fifth person to compete in that Claim the Fame five-way. Will it be the up-and-comer Tokyo Rose, or will it be the experienced veteran, the Cougar, Casey Taylor?
Let's get this match going, guys. More great action. Match after match here on ESW Rise. And here we go, guys. You know, and like you said, this is going to be experience versus inexperience here. And Casey coming off the bat with a Frankensteiner. Rose, you know, but don't take nothing away from Rose. You know, Rose learned how, you know, she learned our craft in Japan with her brother, Tokyo Thunder.
Absolutely well-versed in strong style.
You know, but Casey's well-versed in it. I'm going to kick your ass.
Yeah, that's her style.
Oh, man. Rose with a kick to the gut and drop kick to the temple.
And that's what Tokyo Rose is going to have to rely on, is her speed and quickness.
Oh, man, just taking a tour with some left hands here. Oh, a slap.
Just disrespectful. And we've been seeing a more of a harsher side of Tokyo Rose than ever before lately.
Oh, and I think that's what she needs, to get out of the shadow of her twin brother. Oh, Casey with a big crossbody.
Yeah, taking Tokyo Rose down. It's not that often we see the Cougar take to the skies.
Oh, she knows how to do it. She knows it all. Very well-rounded competitor is Casey Taylor.
Well, one of the greatest diamonds in ESW history.
Oh, hoists her up. Oh, just drops her on her face. Casey getting fired up here.
She's feeling the adoration from this crowd. We've seen this before. Military press.
Oh, into a spine buster.
Man, very impressive by the Cougar, Casey Taylor. Now she's sizing Tokyo Rose up. She's going for it. Sex sells. Oh,
thanks for coming, Tokyo Rose.
Spiking Tokyo Rose into the mat.
Oh, and Rose kicks out.
Rose just barely getting the shoulder up. And Tokyo Rose knows what's at stake in this match.
Oh, for sure.
Now, the Cougar, Casey Taylor, going back up top.
Oh, missed the elbow.
Tokyo Rose moving out of the way.
Oh. Missed that. Oh, Casey with just a boot to the face. Like we said, Casey's offense isn't very pretty. Unlike her.
Very impressive.
Oh, Rose counters that. Counter by Casey. Just back and forth action here. These ladies just going at tooth and nail. They know what's at stake. Oh, Rose firing that, back here.
That fifth spot in the claim to fame four-way.
Five-way.
Yeah, the winner, like I said, will get an ESW Diamonds Championship opportunity anytime, any place.
Oh, Casey. Oh, Scorpion Death Drop. And Casey going to the second rope here. Oh, got the elbow that time. Going for a pin. And Rose kicks out again.
Just in the nick of time.
Rose showing the tenacity.
The heart and determination from Tokyo Rose. And Casey Taylor is just relentless with those kicks. Trying to stomp the life out of Tokyo Rose.
Oh, begging her to get up. What's she have in mind here?
Sizing Tokyo Rose up.
Into the ropes. Oh, Rose just ran through her. Oh, Rose caught her. Oh, STO.
Slams her down.
Oh, kick. Oh, drop kick to the temple.
Catching the Cougar off guard.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, man.
What a bulldog by Tokyo Rose.
Oh, and Casey just kicks out. Oh, Casey just stopping her in her tracks here. I know that rocked her. Sizing her up here. Have in mind, Rose countered out, block again. Oh, right hand is back and forth, guys.
Now she just rolls her up.
Caught her off guard. And she got her.
And that's it. The experienced veteran, the Cougar, Casey Taylor, will go to the claim to fame five-way and compete at WrestleEmpire.
And that match could have gone either way, Stephen.
It really could have, but that veteran experience by the Cougar paid off.
Oh, absolutely. But you got to hand it to Tokyo Rose. Great performance here tonight.
Absolutely. She has nothing to be ashamed of.
All right, there you go, guys. Your winner, Casey Taylor, squeaking it out here.
Let's keep the train moving to our next match. We have one-on-one action making their way out to the ring. First, Dallas Barton and Trey Allen, Ass Kickers Anonymous. Trey Allen in one-on-one competition. This stems from Tag Team Turmoil on the last episode of Rise. You know, Los Asesinos eliminating Ass Kickers Anonymous from the match. And Dallas Barton and Trey Allen just could not let that go. And they assaulted Los Asesinos.
Oh, it was terrible. You know, ultimately costing them the match.
Oh, right you are. Yeah, when they went up against Bludclot in the next round, they were ultimately defeated by Bludclot, Dag, and Sven Carlson. So because of their actions, Los Asesinos have challenged Ass Kickers Anonymous to a tag team match at WrestleEmpire.
Man, listen. Match announcement after match announcement, all bangers.
Absolutely, WrestleEmpire is going to be a must-see event.
Oh, right you are, Steven. And tonight, Trey will face Solido in one-on-one action. And this should be quite a contest. Both these guys, you know, similar in stature, but completely different styles.
Well, you couldn't be more right. You know, very much a clashing of styles here. Here comes Los Asesinos, Mortifero, and Solido. The most exciting tag team, I would say, in ESW.
Oh, right you are, Steven. It's been quite a road for them this season as well. You know, taking a bit of a hiatus and coming back with Eric Acosta to take on the Summit. And they gave the Summit a run for their money.
Yeah, if it wasn't for the actions of Dallas Barton and Trey Allen, they very well could have gone the distance and would be facing Chaz Stevens and Travis Logan once again at WrestleEmpire.
Oh, right you are. And you know, these guys haven't let it go.
Oh, yeah, something like that happens to you. You know, the kind of beating that Dallas Barton and Trey Allen put on Los Asesinos, that's not something you just let go.
Oh, absolutely not. You know, and these guys are from the mean streets of Tijuana. You know, they don't forget.
Oh, absolutely. 100%. Now, Trey Allen in the driver's seat of this match early going.
You know, and you have to think, is Solido at 100% after that beatdown?
I don't think Los Asesinos are at 100%. That was just a vicious assault.
You know, Solido took a powerbomb on the apron and then slung his head into the apron after that. It was nasty.
Absolutely. And Mortifero was, you know, Dallas Barton, you know, powerbombed him through our announce table.
Oh, I know. Right in front of us. It was horrific. Trey Allen, proud of himself here. I wonder if he's drunk here tonight.
Oh, he's always drunk.
He's not the delightful drunk like Brownbeard.
He's not a functioning alcoholic like Brownbeard.
All right, Solido fighting back here. Russian leg sweep. Trey dragging himself up into the corner.
Trying to crawl away from Solido.
Not the first time Trey's crawled away from something. Oh, big leg drop on the back of his head.
Very impressive by Solido.
Oh, Trey fighting back though. Big right hand. Back elbow. Missed the clothesline. Oh, rolled him up.
Inside cradle off one count.
Tie up here. Oh, just dropped his knee right on his face. You know, unlike Ricky Riot, Solido doesn't wear his mask for protection. There's no guard there.
Oh yeah, there's no. It's there for culture.
Exactly. You know, Ricky's mask is there to protect her orbital socket. Oh, Trey. Oh, just drove him down, man.
Referee out of position there.
Oh, and Solido kicks out.
It could have been a three if the referee was in proper positioning.
Yeah, if you say so. All right. Oh, counter. Big clothesline by Solido. Picks him up. Ooh, another counter. Back and forth action here. Oh, Trey just taking it to him. Oh, big clothesline. Oh, punch. Oh, the back headlock. Oh, right into the knees.
We saw that on the last episode of Rise.
Oh, and that's it.
Trey Allen with a huge victory here on Rise.
You know, is this the momentum AA need rolling into WrestleEmpire?
Man, that knee smash.
Oh, nasty.
Very devastating. Your winner, Trey Allen.
Oh, man, you know. What does this do for Los Asesinos going into WrestleEmpire? Alright guys, we have more action here tonight as the King of Catastrophe, Miles Martin, will be facing his cousin, Anthony Martin, here tonight. And breaking news here, more blockbuster announcements at ESW Wrestle Empire. We have a four-way TLC match for the ESW Next Level title as Miles Martin, Anthony Martin, Powerline will challenge Kevin Kincaid. What a match.
That match has slobber knocker written all over it, Cruz.
Oh, man, just blockbuster after blockbuster here tonight.
A TLC match. Kevin Kincaid defends against Miles Martin, Powerline, and this man, Anthony Martin.
And, you know, I don't know how Anthony Martin talked his way into this match.
I think after his actions on the last episode of Fight Night, you know, he put his nose in Miles Martin's business and cost him the match against Powerline.
You know, so, you know, if Anthony can figure something out, which I doubt he can, You know, this could be a game changer for Anthony Martin.
I think this is the, you know, opportunity that Anthony Martin cannot blow. He cannot afford to let this slip by.
Oh, absolutely not. You know, and he's had quite a journey this season on here in ESW, and you know, what a way to culminate it if he's able to somehow walk away from WrestleEmpire, the new next level champion.
It's hard to even see him through all that hair, Cruz.
Now, how long has it been since he washed that shirt?
It doesn't look like it's ever been washed.
All right, guys. One-on-one action. Miles Martin versus Anthony Martin. Family feud reignited here tonight.
This is a match that Miles Martin had demanded to the board of directors, and they have agreed to it.
Oh, and Miles is asserting himself here right off the bat. Oh, just taking out his frustration on his bearded cousin.
I don't blame him one bit. You know, these two cousins, they there's no love lost between them.
Oh, for sure.
Of course, Anthony Martin hailing from the Windy City of Chicago and Miles Martin from London, England.
You know, the Martin family heritage is rather widespread. You know, but don't count Anthony Martin out. He is a very formidable competitor.
Oh, he is. But it's like ever since he lost the crown to Miles Martin, he's just been on a downward spiral.
Oh, I know. He lost to Davey Kaboom.
Yeah, nobody loses to Davey Kaboom.
Well, the Summit did.
Well, are you trying to get on Juan Soto's bad side by bringing that
up?
Well,
I'm just saying, you know, I was just correcting your statement.
Like, that Juan, that he said that, not me.
Fine. I said it. All right, Anthony, stringing together some offense here. Can he do this? Oh. Picks him up. Oh, back suplex. Hangs on to him. Turns into a German. Hanging on. What's he have in mind?
Transitions into a brain buster.
Oh, man. Anthony Martin showing what he can do. It looks like he's getting his mojo back a little here. Look at him. Oh, man.
I wouldn't count your chickens before they hatch, Anthony. You still have to get the 1-2-3 or submission.
Oh, man. Just drove him face first. Oh, there's that Superman punch. Missed the clothesline. Oh!
Shades of the old Anthony Martin.
The former king. Oh, what's he have in mind here? Oh, GTS.
And a German suplex and bridges into the pin.
One, two, and three.
Oh my God, Anthony Martin has picked up a victory.
Dear God.
His first victory in months.
In months.
And against his cousin, Miles Martin.
What does this mean going into WrestleEmpire?
This has to improve his psyche.
Oh, absolutely. Like I said, it looked like he was getting his mojo back, and it has to be back now.
A huge victory over his cousin, the King of Catastrophe, the Disruptor, Miles Martin, your winner, Anthony Martin.
Look at him. He looks like he just cured world hunger.
Will this continue into WrestleEmpire?
All right, guys, it's time for our main event. Here we have tag team action. It's Renegade, Ross Snodgrass, teams with main event Jackson Ave to take on Lars Johansen of Bludclot and the ESW YouTube champion, Sal Moretti.
And we do have more breaking news here as far as WrestleEmpire. It has been confirmed. A fatal four-way match will happen at WrestleEmpire, including all four of these men for the ESW YouTube Championship. The Sal Moretti, the Hitman, will defend his championship against Renegade Ross Snodgrass, main event Jackson Ave, and Lars Johansen of Bludclot.
Man, what an announcement. WrestleEmpire is shaping up to be a monumental event. All right, guys, and out next is the Renegade's partner, the main event, the former ESW YouTube champion, Jackson Ave.
In another main event slot, here comes Jackson Ave. Yeah, you know, these two men were, I have to say, are probably the best YouTube champions in, so far.
Oh, absolutely, so far. I mean, Lars didn't have it long enough to really have a substantial reign, you know, and Sal's reign is just beginning.
These two long reigning YouTube champions.
Oh, yeah.
And these two, they both got their start in the Claim to Fame Battle Royal. It came down to these two men, and ultimately it was Renegade Ross Snodgrass who walked out with the YouTube championship.
Oh, absolutely. And the fact that Jackson Ave impressed ESW board of directors so much, they offered him a contract as well.
And they, them both men have been very impressive in ESW, making a name for themselves here.
Jackson Ave, always bringing it to the table. And out next, one of your favorites, the lead singer of Bludclot.
It's always a party when the lead singer of Bludclot, Lars Johansen, is in the building. And this man is the man who defeated Renegade Ross Snodgrass for the ESW YouTube Championship.
And I would, in what I would call the upset of the season.
You know, it's hard to argue that. It was very much an upset. You know, Lars Johansen, you know, becoming the YouTube Champion. But then, you know, he loses it right away to main event Jackson Ave.
Well, you know.
And ever since then, Bludclot has had a problem with main event Jackson Ave.
Oh, and you think Snodgrass has forgotten?
Oh, he hasn't forgotten one bit.
You know, both Jackson Ave and Snodgrass have voiced their concerns with Bludclot on social media on X. And both of these guys, you know, they have it in for Lars Johansen. I feel bad for Lars. More so than Sal.
Well, but at the same time, you know, it's a fatal four-way, you know, so Sal doesn't have to be pinned to lose his championship.
Right,
he has no champion's advantage.
You are absolutely right. And out next, the mafioso, the hitman, Sal Moretti.
Coming out with this ESW YouTube Championship that he just captured for main event Jackson Ave.
Oh, and he's hanging on to it for dear life. Look at him.
Well, where he's from, if you have a piece of gold like that, you got to keep it protected.
Oh, absolutely. You know, the Morettis are from Jersey, and, you know, where they grew up, it was pretty rough.
Absolutely.
But then again, they ran their neighborhood.
they don't call him the hitman, the mafioso, for nothing.
Oh, right you are.
He's a very dangerous individual.
Sal Moretti bringing gold to the Moretti crime family. You know, and the Moretti crime family had quite a journey this season as well. Sophia bringing gold home at one point. You know, it's been, you know, and the way the fans have received them has changed as well.
Oh, absolutely. They've more or less embraced the Moretti crime family.
You know, I don't know how much they're going to embrace Sal teaming with Lars, but that's not Sal's call, I don't think.
There's a lot of Bludclot fans out there. They've sold a lot of records, Cruz.
Yeah, like 20 years ago.
Again, with this...
With the honesty,
with the honesty, with the bias.
Oh, Snodgrass taking it to him. Oh man. Oh, DDT. Like I said, Snodgrass has not forgotten, but Lars coming out with a clothesline,
taking the Renegade down and immediately tagging back out.
Do you blame him? Oh, and Sal just driving him down.
You know, I think everyone in this match has some sort of problem with Lars Johansen.
Yeah, I wouldn't doubt if Sal does by the end of this.
I think they're all just jealous of his hair.
He does have good hair. I'm sure Snodgrass is terribly jealous.
All the Bludclot guys have tremendous hair.
Yeah, I've heard their wigs.
You hush your mouth, Cruz.
I'm just saying what I heard.
That is a nasty, dirty rumor.
Just saying. I'm not saying it's true.
It's bordering on libel. Slander.
It's just what I heard. Sal picks him up. Oh, man, with a white noise there. And Sal tagging Lars, whether he wanted to be tagged or not. You know, turnabout's fair play, I guess. But Lars coming in with some offense.
And these two, no strangers to one another. Like I said, Lars Johansen defeated Renegade Ross Snodgrass for the YouTube Championship. And he's tagging in the main event, Jackson Ave, the man who beat Lars Johansen for the title. So all four of these men are intertwined.
Oh, for sure. Oh, Lars is standing shooting star press. Very impressive.
A tag back in to Sal Moretti.
Oh, big clothesline by Jackson Ave. Oh, man. Oh.
Oh, man. What a dive to the outside by main event Jackson Ave.
Showing off the athleticism here. Oh.
Oh, right into the ring post.
Bleeding.
It busted him wide open with that shot.
That's the thing about these Moretti's. They seem to bleed awful easily. Oh, run to the corner of the table. Oh, that may have injured Jackson Ave there.
And the Moretti's are no strangers to their own blood.
Oh, absolutely not.
They're no strangers to blood in general.
Oh, wait a minute. What's Sal doing to Snodgrass out here? Oh, DDT'd
man.
On the apron. Taking him out of the equation. The Hitman putting the hit out. Oh, but main event. Firing back. Oh, missed the super kick. Sal missed the knee.
We got a knee of his own. Now main event Jackson Ave. That's Salvatore Moretti.
Oh,
man.
Oh, man. To the back of the neck.
Weakening the YouTube champion.
Oh, big collision there. Sal taking advantage.
Snowplow. Oh. That's the move that won him the YouTube title.
Oh, man. Block. Kick. Another block. Back and forth action here. Oh, man, the Haluva kick.
Lights out, Salvatore Moretti.
Jackson Ave getting ready. What's he have in mind here?
A Death Valley driver.
Oh, man.
Lars Johansen saving the matchup.
Oh, man, back and forth here. Main event trying to take out Lars, and he just did. Oh, and Sal, big right hand.
Just popped him right in the mouth and now setting him up in the tree of woe.
Oh, main event fighting out. Taking him down. Straight right hands. Big punch, what we have here.
And the hit out. He put the hit out on main event Jackson Ave. Into the cover. Oh, Snodgrass saving the matchup. That could have been it if it wasn't for Renegade Ross Snodgrass.
Oh, I agree. Oh, another white noise.
Now main event rolling to the outside.
Tagged Lars.
In comes the lead singer of Bludclot.
Oh, and he takes out Snodgrass. For no reason. Oh, man. Big crossbody on the outside on the Snodgrass.
Trying to take Snodgrass out of the equation.
Oh. You very well could.
And this match is just about breaking down right now.
Oh, for sure. Oh, right in front of us. Oh, Jackson Ave.
Goodness.
Oh, and Snodgrass is aided again. It's pretty much just a one-on-one match right now.
It's down to Jackson Ave and Lars Johansen.
Oh, and Lars, the only man left standing. Jackson fighting back. Lars picks him up. Oh,
back
man.
Suplex on the outside mat.
Paper thin.
Man. barely any protection, and now Lars Johansen really feeling it.
Not
but got run rocked.
For his antics. Oh, wait a minute, he has him up.
Oh, the Death Valley driver once again.
On the floor, man. These guys are pulling out all the stops.
Now back into the ring.
Oh, big elbow to the spine.
Springboard elbow drop.
Oh, Sal with a cheap shot. Oh, Jackson fires back. Drop kick. Oh, Lars.
Float over DDT. Lars Johansen battling back.
Oh, big clubbing blow. Another DDT, and looks like Jackson Ave's been busted open. Going up top. Oh, that frog splash. That's the movie won the title with. Oh, and Snodgrass breaking it up there.
Saving the matchup. Very well could have gotten the job done once again with that frog splash.
Oh, drop kick to the side of the head.
Fighting back.
Oh, when he was going for that Death Valley driver again. Lars fighting out of it though. Oh, just lifted him up.
Face first into the mat. Now, oh!
Frog splash again.
Into a cover.
One, two. Oh, and Snodgrass at the very last second.
Man, if it wasn't for Renegade Ross Snodgrass, Lars Johansen would have pulled out another victory.
And he's up again. Oh, third. Lars is just pulling it out, all the stops. You know, you got to give it to Lars. He's really, you know, bringing it here.
Renegade Ross Snodgrass again saving the matchup.
Oh, man. Big rolling neck breaker.
What a maneuver by Lars Johansen. And now tags in the ESW YouTube champion, Salvatore Moretti.
Sal picking him up here. Oh, just raking his face.
Jackson Ave.
Oh, big German. Jackson Ave just getting rocked here tonight.
They have successfully isolated. But Renegade Ross Snodgrass continuing to stick his nose in the match, saving the matchup.
Right back into the wrong corner.
This is not where you want to be if you're main event Jackson Ave.
Oh, drop toe hold into an elbow drop.
What double team maneuvering by Sal Moretti and Lars Johansen. Working great as a team.
Oh, but Lars just got rocked by Snodgrass. Oh, man.
Knocked off the apron.
Oh, again. Another quick tag. You know, Moretti and Johansen aren't a bad team.
Yeah, they make a great team.
I don't think their lifestyles are quite the same, but at least for tonight, they make a good team.
You know, it's like Paula Abdul said, opposites attract.
I guess so. Oh, big chops. Lighting him up. Oh, Jackson Ave is being, you know, destroyed here.
Renegade Ross saving the match once again.
I mean, what kind of shape is Jackson Ave going to be in for WrestleEmpire?
You got to wonder that.
Oh, wait a minute.
Inside cradle.
Oh, and Sal kicks out.
Just in the nick of time. That was almost it.
No, oh, absolutely. Oh, finally whipped into the other corner. Finally made a tag with Snodgrass.
Now we see some double team maneuvering of their own.
Oh, big knee to the temple.
And these two men have a ton of respect for one another.
Oh, later, Lars. Now, wait a minute.
We'll be setting up for that jackhammer.
Oh, countered.
Sal Moretti had it well scouted.
Oh, combinations into that DDT.
Seen this before. And it looks like he'd be going for the jackhammer once again. And he connects into the cover. Lars Johansen saving the match at the last second.
Oh, Snodgrass taking it to Johansen here. Oh, look at the strength.
Oh my God, what a suplex.
And Lars is out.
By Renegade Ross Snodgrass.
Oh, big kick.
Now a tag in to Jackson Ave. That hammerlock DDT.
Oh man, that could be it. And that's it.
Your winners, Renegade Ross Snodgrass, and main event Jackson Ave.
What a main event.
Huge main tag team main event here on Rise, the go home edition of Rise before WrestleEmpire.
Right you are. Man, big win for Jackson Ave and Ross Snodgrass. You know, we'll see who comes out ahead, you know, at WrestleEmpire in the Fatal 4-Way. But big win here tonight. Has to be great for the momentum. All right, guys. Thank you so much for joining us here on our go-home episode of Rise. I am Cruz de la Cruz.
And I'm Stephen Fiennes, saying like, comment, subscribe, and ring the notification bell.
All right, guys. We will see you at WrestleEmpire.